Witness the firepower of this fully armed and operational Firebird. Howdy folks, and welcome back to Arc Patreon Extinction. You can already see from my outfit that a couple things have changed since the last time you saw me here. So, let's have a quick look around. We have a Stargate, now look at that. I don't know if I already told you that, I'm pretty sure I haven't. We had to get rid of all the lovely teleporters that we had and put in the Stargates again, because there seems to be an issue with the Alpha Wyverns. Whenever they are in drawing distance, while you use a teleporter, you teleport that Alpha Wyvern too. And, you know, if that's like 300-500 meters away from you, but still within drawing distance, and you teleport to a new location, it puts it relative to the teleport pad in the same distance, so that might be in the middle of a mountain, and then it drops underneath that mountain or something. And we've lost quite a few of those. Now that might be the Tabula Rasa mod, the Scorched Earth Alpha Wyverns. It might be the Extinction Core Alpha Wyverns. We haven't figured that out. Didn't really care. We've just, you know, put the Stargate back in. It's back. Not overly happy about that, I have to say, because those teleport pads... we did get the same loading glitch, where we basically have to wait like 20 seconds. I think in actuality it's 17 seconds, it's actually quite bad. Whenever I step through the gate into an area I have been to before I logged in, well, after I logged in, then I have to wait 17 seconds before the game actually starts moving again. I can be attacked in that time, I can, if I'm on a flyer or if I'm on a creature and I'm teleporting to a mountain or something, if I step through the gate I might just, you know, shut off in the distance. And I had that first when I tried to teleport to the floating island. The moment I could actually move, the moment the screen loaded, what happened was I was nearly in the swamp. It shot me off over the island, over that, well, that empty area where it goes down in the water into the swamp. And I just, you know, I immediately hit the shortcut for ghost, because I jumped off afterwards. I was like 2 meters from the ground. If I had hit that ground, my Alpha Dodorex, he would have been dead. And I know that those are not the deaths we're doing here. If I get killed, okay, that's fine. That's me being stupid, but, you know, not because of a game glitch or something. Death from Above, still the most ballerific creature I have. Max level 961, has a jungle costume. Looks quite weird. I mean, it's all leafy and stuff. Look at that. I tried the snow costume, it's just pure white, you can't see anything. This looks like a mixture of mossy, cobblestone, gargoyle, and leaves. That should have been on a tree. There's no brown in here, no wood. It's just... it's a statue with a bush. And what you could hear there is this. That's Fox. We tamed a 540, 580, something like that. Firebird. Are you max level yet? No, you're not even close. This creature is awesome. Come on, let's use some more of those. I have them, why not? Only eats cooked prime meat, so it's currently using up my food supply. Nothing I can do against that. Hey, I clicked you. Oh yeah, you're... This light bluish outline here, they could have made that yellow or something and all the way around so that you actually see it. I don't know. Anyway, some more levels. It's all going into melee at this point. It came with like 34,000 health, and then I put one point in, it didn't seem like much, so I just hit the macro for, you know, give it 40 levels. I have to do 50 levels anyway before I put the rest into melee, and then all of a sudden I was at 400,000. Movement speed is really, really bad. 175 is barely adequate, but I can't put any more in there, otherwise I don't get enough melee out of it. It's too many points in here. 200,000 would have been enough, you know? We might just get another one at some stage. This thing is ballerific. I'm gonna try that later. Also, the ancient workbench is back, obviously. And I still don't have a chemistry bench. Which I don't need. I mean, we have this thing. It does everything for us. What did I do the spark powder for? That's a good question. For something. I needed it for something. Spark powder and stimberries, right? Yeah, makes this. What do I need that for? For detox. Now, the farm is still going. I had to restock a couple of times. But now we actually have at least a row of fertilizer in everyone, and this thing is quite nicely stocked. 86. We have 20 crop plots. Yeah, it's 4 more for each of them. How are you looking? 15, it's good. I logged in like 5 minutes ago and it was empty, so yeah, I dig it. You go in here. What happened here? Everything got reordered again. That's so nice. Whenever this mod updates, there's something new. Bag of cakes. Gives 10 veggie cakes when opened. We could do that. Cool. This is what I wanted. Anything else from the get-go? I guess some more kibbles were added. I'm not gonna go through all of them. Anything else in here? Let's just have a quick look. Still unlearned engrams. We need a button for that. There's the Stargate stuff. Everything else looks to be from the first look. Looks okay. No, don't see anything. Good. So how did we tame that Firebird? Well, you can go and watch Bowden's video. He just did that, like, it was released 2 or 3 days ago. I pretty much used the same method. Just dropped the cage on top of it and then shot it with arrows. That worked quite nicely. Also, since we've been leveling that guy and that guy... Dude, we got all the gems and we got all the essence. The only thing we don't have is these two, because I used them up, all of them. We have pearls, I made a crap ton of pearls, and narcotics. And do we need to refill anything? We could make some more sedatives. Can we make more sedatives? Consumables, drugs. Give me a sedative. How many could we make? 88. That's not much. It's probably the mushrooms? I don't remember how many that takes. Also, some of the costs were adjusted by the mod author, so actually doing arrows now. Headed 1, that still seems to be the same. So we still have our override in place. We might want to check that out, you know, have a quick look at single player and see if that's more reasonable the way they are now and see if we adapt to that and revert back. Then we have a new box just for skins, all the skins. We got a few of them, looks quite good. Nothing that we would really use for our creatures. And prime gear. And I have a full set of, well, cloth, if you ever need that. It's quite cheap to make, it's really only fiber and some prime hide. And obviously you need that, the original cloth item, armor item, the boots, the pants and stuff. Woolly rhino horns, that could get expensive. We'll see if you ever want to make that. Again, full set. We're missing the hat for the desert stuff, which uses prime pelt. Now, making these is quite cheap. As you can see, 150 is not that much. You can get that from a Yeti easily. But then again, if you want to upgrade these to a higher tier, you know, the cost increases. So, this seems to be the cheapest so far for a good armor value. Armor 100? Yeah, it's good. That needs a lot of black pearls, but then also just only prime hide, so it might not be that expensive. We do have a full set of chitin and we do have a full set of metal. That would be worth it. I am missing the boots for the fur. Of course, needs a lot of prime pelt, so we're not going to do that at all. We don't need it. I mean, 242, come on. It gets cold sometimes, but we never get the ice cube. Ghillie? Sure. Don't know if I want to upgrade that, but if we want to sneak up on something for a passive tame, yeah, we go Ghillie. Sure, why not? Got the scuba stuff, which is quite amazing. I mean, think about this. A prime scuba tank, which is unbreakable. So it has no durability. So that means the oxygen that usually depletes and the item breaks when it's depleted, because it actually is not the oxygen decreasing, it's the durability while you wear it. It doesn't go down. We have unlimited oxygen. There it goes. There, right there. Whatever we need, it doesn't weigh that much, so yeah, sure. And we have a full set of riot gear, and look at that cost. I mean, prime blood, 700, and black pearls? The height is not the issue. Amethyst? Sure, we get those from killing science and stuff, and yeah, a little fiber. You know, usually riot gear is quite expensive because you have to repair it all the time and you need polymer and all that stuff. In modded, it's not that difficult, and this you don't need to repair, you just need to upgrade it once. Still, 700 prime blood for the regular stuff. Now let's have a quick look if we want to upgrade that, because I'm wearing currently, you saw that. If I would want to upgrade that, you can actually use higher tier, higher quality items for the upgrade. Or for crafting this, it just says, you know, you need the standard riot gear for the blueprint of the prime riot gear, but you can actually use one of these. Let's put this in here and say, attempt upgrade. 789 more blood and 451 more pearls, so that's 80 more and 50 more. That's what? 12.5, 13% or something? And that goes up, presumably. I don't have that yet. I spent all of it making this and making these four. We do have all the saddles now. I mean, we already have the Dodorex and we already have the Manticore. So we have the Megapisicus saddle, we have the Dodo Wyvern, the Broodmother, and the Dragon saddle now. And the Dragon has now been modified. It's supposedly a little bit smaller. So we're going to fly around and have a look. This guy killed four dragons at the same time. They were just ganging up on me and I didn't even see them coming. I saw one, level 100, and said, yeah, let's try it. It's good XP. And all of a sudden, four more were there. And they all spawned their fire wyverns and stuff. That was quite a thing. I couldn't hit record at that time because OBS wasn't running. Otherwise, it would be a key press. But I had to alt-tab out, start the program, wait for it to load, and then start recording. By the time, I would have been dead. So, sorry, you're not going to see that. I mean, this is our Patreon server. I already told you we're not going to go and do everything together. I'm just going to show you the fun we are having, basically. And I'm not gonna spoil it, but there is some more fun coming soon after PAX. Yeah, let's just leave it at that. So what am I gonna do today? One thing I constantly run out of is fiber, and usually you go and get a Gigantopithecus for that. Well, it turns out you can use an Alpha Direbear, for example. I always wanted to have one of those. We're gonna have a look around and see if we can get one of those going for us. So we're already quite ways into the video, like halfway, just from explaining. I meet you right back and we get straight to the action. Look what I found! That's a Titanosaur, and it is an extinction Titanosaur. You see that because it has Terminator Torpor. It has 5% melee damage, that's awesome. Now, if it wasn't for that Firebird down there, I would have attacked that already. I'm waiting for that to go away, but it seems like Firebird is a little bit mad on the Titanosaur because it's following it around. And the only thing that this guy can't handle is another Firebird, really. It's weird. Let's have another look. What the? Oh, you're smashing things to bits. Alright. Let's see. Ah, this glow. It's a little bit of a bummer when you're sitting here. Can't get a reading on that. Okay, well, if we try to stay above, shouldn't be a big deal. Now, witness the firepower of this fully armed and operational Firebird. Here you go, right click. Does an initial 7,000-8,000 damage, and then it does burn damage. Damage over time, see that? That's absolutely awesome. Oh, it has this nice slow effect. Cool, can I hit you from here? No, that would have been... Oh, yes, I can. I just want to say, that would have been too nice, but I actually can. So I will. What's hitting me? Is that you? Are you being rude to me? Burning. Look at those damage values. This is slightly OP, because this damage is stacking. And it's killing it. There you go. Now you can go home. What level are you? 460. I don't even want to try. So, what did we get from that? 20,000? That's cool. Another melee point or two. Nice, very nice. I'm still looking around for an Alpha Direwolf. Haven't really found... Hello. 240, and you're just getting roasted. Awesome. Bye. Last one I found was a level 40, so we're getting up there. Two more and we should be level 600, right? Isn't that how it works? That's Ark, right? Whenever you're looking for something, you get exactly what you want. That is definitely Ark. Come here. Some more XP. And you're dead. we've been playing around with the spawn settings. I recently saw my first Alpha Spinosaurus down over at the Volcano Island. That was great. Yeah, that was great. We sat there, like, the Firebird and I, we sat there, and we were so happy that we found him, and we laughed, and then the Spine laughed at us, and then we killed the Spine. It was good times all around. So, let me find... Hello, Scion. I'm not gonna tackle that. But just yet. Let me see if I can find one that's suitable for taming, and I'll be right back. What do you know? I guess that's enough. It's not even glowing. I mean, we're in the red ones and they are glitchy. Some of the effects just don't play. This one is definitely not glowing, but it is an alpha. Although it looks like a regular bear. Oh, it's glowing a bit. But it's not red or anything, so... I don't mind. Alpha's alpha. Stay still. Well, you certainly held up your end of the bargain. I just overshot. Oh, let's try. Nope, that's the wrong thing. Oh well. Can you do? Have one. Come on. Losing more arrows by not hitting than I'm actually losing by trying to tame stuff. See, that works. That's fine. Stay there. That's four. That's five. If I would wait for 5 seconds between shots so that the whole damage over time or torpor over time can be done, then I would use seven or less arrows per creature because it's a percentage-based thing. I don't mind. No, I have it. That one and one of those. It's Carno Kibble if you want to know. Yeah, it actually is. Perfect. 100%. And we do have enough kibble. Nice. Let's get on here. Just in case. You. Also, this damage, 8,000, is definitely not right. I mean, that's, what, 11,000 damage barely we just did to that? That thing has more than 11,000 health. I think that's also percentage based, because killing a Titanosaur, I can do that with, like, 10 hits. Well, 10 times these 8,000 damage, thank you, would be, what, 80,000? Include as much damage over time, so 160,000. These creatures have 400,000-600,000 health. So, yeah, there's something wrong there. I don't mind, it's a little OP. Come here. Oh, 749, oh, very nice. Very nice, perfect aim for 500. Objections there. So, I guess I'm gonna guide this guy, lady? Guy. Back to the Stargate. Here's a saddle. So, here's your saddle. Ooh, look at that. That is... Smithy. Nice. 130,000 health. Good. Stamina. Yeah, sure. Doesn't need that much. I mean, it's not flying. 160 movement speed. Probably not that good. Weight is good. Better than most of the stuff I have. Yeah, I'm gonna guide this guy back to the Stargate. Send this guy home and then we're gonna have a run through the woods and see what we can do, I think. And maybe not run into any tribes. Well, we'll see. Maybe we just go through the snow biome. We'll see in a second. So two-thirds of us made it back to the Stargate. I have the saddle. Well, we came straight around that corner over there. The Stargate is right there on a rock in the water. We came around that corner and the dire bear got swarmed by two level 40 of these. It died within 22 seconds. Couldn't do anything against that. They seem to be pretty immune to each other's damage. Or at least the damage there is the damage you actually do, like the 2000 or whatever it is, and not this huge amount. So I'm a little bit mad now, and as I flew across here, I heard music. Yeah, you're gonna die. Somebody has to pay for it, right? There. Yeah, you don't like that, huh? You actually can't reach me up here, but I can reach you. Oh, you're spawning stuff. That's good. See all the numbers? It's all green. You're dead. There's no yellow number here. You can't reach me. Oh, they take reduced damage. Look at that. It's interesting. They're, okay, level 1800. And dead. So, let's see if at least we get something out of this. Anybody? No. Yeah, I'm taking that. Thank you. This buggy landing. Whenever you hit spacebar because you want to fly off and then notice it already flew off and starts to land now, you can't interrupt that process. That's one of the buggy things. You cannot press spacebar again and just keeps on flying like you would be able to on a, let's say, Pteranodon or RG. No, it has to land. That's a bit weird. Oh, that's good. That's a lot of pearls. I do have like 6 or 7 of those, thank you. I do not need any of this. I'm keeping these because I can put these in the grinder and get the resources for them, and that's how I got most of my fiber at the moment. Okay, I have like 6 or 7 of those, never used them. Yeah, I keep that stuff. Hello, epic alpha ankylo saddle. Oh, I do have an alpha ankylo, thank you very much. So the apex drop epic, or at least upgraded alpha saddles, that's new. Also, holy XP! That was a strafing run, it was 2 attacks. Oh yeah, I thought I might get up to 5-5, but I got up to 7. Now that's cool. I just put this little more into weight. Let's see how much damage that actually is. That's not enough. Yeah, that's whatever health it had. Is there anything big around here? And by big, I mean Titan. Or maybe, where's that Scion that we saw earlier? That must have been somewhere around here. Kill you. 10,000. Nice. That's a quarter more than it did before. And that rhymes. That's good. It's getting dark. Don't care. When I go alpha hunting, I like it dark because then I can see the glow. Not that that helps any in the redwoods when you can't see any glow in the redwoods. Oh well. Always something, right? Now, stay away from me. Oh, these firebirds are so much trouble, but they are so much fun at the same time. As long as they are tamed. I know there was a Scion around here somewhere. I know we're doing a little overtime on the video, but I do want to see if I can kill something with like 800,000 health. I can kill something with 400,000. There's really... Ooh. No reason why I shouldn't be able to. Hey, there, I hear you. That's a bear. Now, I did try attacking one of these earlier, and I got a costume from it. That's where the Manticore got his costume from. One of the patrons also brought me that same costume. So, yeah. It's just, I attacked it with the Alpha, what was it, Dodorexy, and that got torpored by it. Now, Boden attacked quite a few of these and never got a torpor effect. Might just be because he used the Broodmother and they are not prone to torpor. I don't know. Can I hit you from here? Yes, I can. Now, I should get... This thing doesn't have much torpor. That's the issue. I should get the reduced movement effect out of that, but this thing just doesn't seem to care. Now, can I just quickly check how much health you actually have? 680. Almost hit E there instead of Q. I would have been quite deadly because my bird is on passive. I'm gonna kill you. You can't do anything about that. Looks a bit weird. Because I'm in that sphere. Also, if you ever see one of these, instead of a sphere having a halo, do not engage. That is the upgrade version in Anunnaki, you would have called them the Wardens. It's a deity. That's the biggest Scion you will ever see. They come with like 25 billion health? Takes a while. No, why is nothing happening here? I'm doing the damage required. Just took a while. You, sir, need to die. Thank you. Where? There. I think. You're not coming to me, right? No. These have an aggro range that is vicious. I mean, once you aggro them, they pretty much follow you around the whole map until you get out of rendering distance. And when you come back, they follow you again. It takes about, I don't know, 15 minutes to shake them loose? So they actually lose interest? It's weird. Now let's see what we got. Jungle rhinoceros costume. Don't know what I would use that for, but I take the huge experience potion, sure. 8,000 enough? Oh, hello. That was more than I expected. That's what happened with health. Like, okay, it must be like 5 levels and then, 40 levels spent. We should have a couple more to spend. If I get this up to 10,000, I will do it. I mean, this is more than enough weight, definitely is. Alright. I guess I just keep this. It's wasted on here. I mean, it gives us 20,000. That's like the third digit. I'm just gonna kill a couple more science and level it up to max. The science have been buffed when you kill them. They give more XP than they did before. I just noticed that is actually true. Yeah, I'm just gonna see if I can find two or three more of those, and then I can call it a day. But that's it for today, guys. If you like the video, subscribe for more, leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourselves. That looks creepy and scary at the same time. See you soon. Bye-bye.